Chapter 85 verse 11. Now, you know what I call seeing our Bible prophecy. They see now a gun, I say now Bible prophecy. But you name, you need myself zombies, and any nam, you ain't care about, you know what I so. Read. The book of Psalms, chapter 85, verse 11. Truth shall spring out of the earth. Now, people say, no crown of us that it says bring it out. I see no crown of us that it says about. I see that truth shall spring out of the earth. Read. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. I see, and righteousness shall look down upon heaven. Meaning what? A man for best, I say, no, didn't you coupon man seven or so? Then for best, I say, didn't you coupon man seven or so? But your leaders don't see you coupon man seven, and you do but Bible, no, I can't defend him. Read that again, bro. Psalms 85 verse 11. Truth shall spring out of the earth. I see no crown best bring you out of the earth. Like they say, no crown best that is a Babylon. No crown best that is a Babylon. You are sleeping because who says he see? Who says I got so bad in man? No crown in your view. You can't no crown enter. So who can no crown enter? You just say, but God just said, be our time no. But so who can enter? But who can enter? Say everybody no crown. Continue. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. See, and righteousness shall look down upon heaven. Give me Nehemiah 8:8. See, and the understanding of the Bible, and so question be true again. But never beside it. Yeah, the Bible and the Bible and some questions now. Yeah, mommy, for a papa, for a more question, I say. Mom, brother, but in the answer, and there are leaders in the moon, yeah, ready some babies, and there are some questions now. Nehemiah chapter 8 verse 8. And they read in the book of the law of God distinctly. That's the Bible. I see that you read the word, the Bible, and do what? And they read in the book of the law of God distinctly. And gave the saints. And do what? And gave the saints. And they say, and they like I say, well, understanding that the man wants out the prayer. But you're back on according to what? The Bible, what God says. Into our question, we are not be our words. You better Bible now and sound questions now, ma'am. Your younger side, my younger side, your own feelings, questions, and our answers. But Bible, we never mind our answers, you know. Read that from you on. Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 8. And they wrote in the book of the law of God, distinctly, and gave the sense. And we gave the sense of who we are according to the Bible. Read. And cause them to understand the reading. I see your man won't see idea also about what the Bible says. See your Bible is so no. Sana yanka and chairman that won't see as you. Mammy Luke 14:23. It is a name where you can see that. Your Bible won't say now already now. With the mommy. Luke 14:23. The book of Luke, chapter 14, verse 23. And the Lord said unto the servant, go out into the highways and the hedges. And yet I happen to be genasi because I see soon I could pass my. I see a man the highways and the hedges. It's another day, Jaya was. Highways of what? Of the street. The highways of what? Of the street and the hedges. So, yeah, everybody, we go out into the highways and the hedges and compel them to come in. I could pass say we should compare our brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers, young ones to come in. Meaning what? Yet you are more acquired. Sam Nana Susan made in Yakupon Rasam or so. Then I know you're a Jinasia. I want Susan Yakupon now. One man, others say, Beginasi. They are kind of called a tremor. And they are up and they are Begina and they can say we are a tremor. Asusun Yakupo na asuma e. Se me kache ugana fwa se. Muna muye Israel fwa no. A babu ni kama o se. Inyama ya kosu o yasi na o. E ye babu prophecy. Mushe accident ino sisi si ugana ase ni na. Ni na ye babu prophecy. by the pastors who and come here and pastor who entry. And when they are politics, I'm only there about the other than who. Big bro, bro, brothers, Mumbra, Mumbra Nenshadi, Mumbra Vijinasi. Bro, what you say? The first thing. Godfrey, now where? Marty, okay. Maybe someone question, bro. He would do a wanna. He may do a wanna. Hey, Nipa, where wanna? Nipa, but I can't open some more children here. No more can image me out. Yes, me, Mali. Okay. What could look at a bad one? What could be any yes, you are? Bon, she. Okay. Never, never know what I see. Brothers, never know what I see. Where we are, never know what I see. The sisters can brother self and never in the yard. Because only the same man is one who are barely local. I mean, bad boy for nothing. Bad boy is an amateur. Amateur or bad boy. You are Chicago and I'm a year already. Walk on local, revelation. Walk on local, according to bad boy, Mene, money of beer, walk on bad boy, bad describe. I mean, read verse one for me.
Revelation 1 verse 1, the revelation of Jesus Christ.
When I get revelation of Jesus Christ, what about Jesus and a born again? The Bible on back to be a color yo. Born shishi. Because okay, if you're a lawyer, I'll allow yourself one image there, then maybe Mali. If you saw him to Provana, she and Provana can imagine a cow after Jesus Christ, be Mali. But what read the Bible on the quay? Go ahead, you know, read.
The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him to show to his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
And then you might get your church John the Revelator. I can own my bad women, look at for Shiao. If I should be queer, a Baba Lakao, born at the year. What could I imagine? John, I can take for Shiao. Read the verse 14.
Revelation 1 verse 14. His head and his hands were white like wool.
Yeah, okay. If it about white, woolly hair. Mene, can mene, number of chair for white. Mene, okay. Did you read about where he are? Come and me, Mali. Okay, wait, continue.
Revelation 1 verse 14. His head and his hands were white like wool. As white as snow.
That one down, we can feel many colors. If you are here, to be born a rock of panel, born a chair, born a bit of here. Now can you press with a chair for here, Tomine? We.
As white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Hey, you put them on that. If it's more. Fire. Take a fire on the fire, you know. Fire is what? La. Gonna. But I can't read the prophecy. Prophecy about John Bini, you may put them on la. Go to the prophecy, Genesis 49, verse 12. What was the reason why I came here to Tumola? Wait.
The book of Genesis, chapter 49, verse 12. His eyes shall be red with rain.
I can't say his eyes shall be red with rain. But I can't only one be at the wrong way about the mini color. About two, one and a beer. Because according to prophecy, I can't the Christ, Messiah's eyes shall be red with wine. Doesn't mean there's fire coming out from his eyes. But his eyes have been red, right? Because he drank wine in moderation. Okay, that is name you read.
Revelation 1 verse 15. And his feet like unto fine brass.
Yeah, a feet from a fine brass. Born our color, born our feet. Our feet for our body, they're the same color. Born and here. John, they're not brass feet. A feet from a brown. Brown, okay? Born out. That's brown, wood.
As if they burn in a furnace.
As if they burn in a furnace. Get where on them. Mishaela, about a mini color. About a mini. Black. About a black. Now we're standing where you are above them. Jesus Christ, Mali. According to Jesus Christ, a mini color.
Black.
Jesus Christ is a black man. But I'm here. Get Christ of God here. My brother, I'm going to give you a bow after Jesus Christ. Ma, I'm going to give you a bow.
If Jesus Christ is a black man, why do our pastors teach us that Jesus Christ is a so-called white man? Because what? As a black person, how can you have a so-called white person to rule? To rule over you? Somebody put you into slavery. How can the same person come and save you again? Is that possible? Our people are sleeping. We are walking like zombies. Christianity has made us like zombies, walking and dead people. But we are here to let you know that Christ is a black man like you and I. Understood? What is Israel here? Get a care Gambia, Gambia, and go from watching. Israel. Only Lako with Israel. Only. Hello? Yeah, I don't know Lako with Israel. Only the data. What can be with Israel? Take Gambia, what the Ogana, what can with Israel? I'm not with this to come, no Kanoko. Read Deuteronomy 28. Now, what they give me sons of Solomon. What crack? Mommy, Baba, Jesus Christ is a black man. What crack? A four-father circle. Read. The Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 5. I am black.
I am what?
I am black. Solomon, okay, your meaning. I am black. Solomon, okay, you're black. Solomon, Papa G. King David. Okay, Solomon, okay. A skin color, your black hair. If Papa David there was skin color about a minute. About a black, you malay. Okay, well, give me Job 30:30. Bro, you are here. Bro, come over and learn, okay? Come here. If you have a question, you can ask, okay? Come over, read Job 30:30. Wait. The book of Job, chapter 30, verse 30. My skin is black upon me. Oh, no, need Job, okay? Okay, what? My skin is black upon me. Okay, his skin is black upon me. These are our forefathers. They are saying they are black. But why do we fear the Bible? Because people thought well, the Bible is a so-called white man book. Ke Bible, white man being I mean my Bible. My Bible if I make a white word, man. Now make she black here, man. Give me Jeremiah 14 verse 2. Bona delusion account of her. Sis, Baba, how she be? Sis, Baba. Ba 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 ba. Bani ba 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 biye. Kasi bono ebi ane. Read Jeremiah 14 verse 2. The book of Jeremiah chapter 14 verse 2. Judah knoweth, and the gates thereof languish. They are black unto the ground. You can't do so with black. Sis, sis. Go for meter man or sister here. Sis, baby meter man will question you. Sis, can I tell princess say, princess. Princess, military is a new one. Princess, you know that you are a princess, right? Take care of princesses. I know you look at me about very attractive calm of Fiamo. In what? In modest way, in Malay. A show on the Fiano care Baba out. On the Fiano buying Ina, in Malay. Okay, I call you princess. But, straight question. Have you dressed as a princess? No, why? Because you are a princess, so you're supposed to dress as what? As princess. So, the attire that you are wearing, is it in the modern ways? Is it in the right way for you to dress like this? No. Right? Because what? You've not been taught the Bible. That's why you are walking. You don't know what is going on. Let me give you one commandment. Because you disobey God's commandment, and it is going on now. That's why sin is going on. It's keeping on. But let me give you, if our sisters try to dress decent, fornication, adulteries, and all those things will stop. Since look at something, Deuteronomy 22 verse 5. Read. Deuteronomy chapter 22 verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertains unto a man. Have you seen? Says, God says what? The woman must not wear that which pertains unto a man. When a brother said, no, you're here. Brother said, minimal war. If you come out, try this, minimally. The sister said, is it right for sisters to put on trousers? No. Have you seen? Read that again for me. Deuteronomy 22 verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertains unto a man. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God. Sis, if we the men here are wearing skirts, what do you think of us? What are some of the things you say about we the men if you are wearing skirt? What do you think? Bwana, I can mean it. Or both of them. I mean it.
gay Jew, allo lesbian Jew, born and Libyan. But you are there, the women also must not wear something which pertains to what? The men. So if sisters are wearing something that belongs to the men, how will God see those people? How will God see you if you are wearing something that belongs to the man? Meaning God says, so it's an abomination for a sister to dress like that. Born a sis. Sis, you can't forget me. You are mercy, your name is called mercy, but you need to show mercy unto your people by why? Dressing decently. Show them what? The proper way to dress as a sister. Understood? Let me give you. Wearing that crown, if there are so many things that is going to happen, and it's going on, Deuteronomy 28, verse 61. Because our people don't see all those things, and our pastors are not telling us, and it is happening. I want you to testify for us now. Verse 61.
Deuteronomy 28, verse 61. Also, every sickness.
Now, God says, every sickness, brothers, you are listening. God says, because we disobey God's commandments. So, God says, every sickness,
also, every sickness, and every plague.
The plague means what? Diseases, read.
Which is not written in the book of this law.
Sickness that are not written in the Bible. HIV, gonorrhea, syphilis, chicken pox, rashes, whites, odepua, which are not written in the Bible. COVID-19, Ebola, which is not written in the Bible.
Then will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed.
When sisters wear trousers for the old day and they remove their trousers, what do you think it will come on their body? Rashes, their body will stink. Have you seen? They have skin rashes, all those types. But still our sisters are wearing it. And when sisters wear those things, rashes, their inner part, give me Isaiah 3, verse 16. Are you there? Isaiah 3.
Isaiah chapter 3, verse 15. What mean ye that you beat my people into pieces?
What do you mean that you beat my people into pieces? You know, he's talking about our pastors. Our pastors are beating us into pieces. You know what? They are destroying us as a people. They've destroyed us that what? Christ is a white man. Whilst according to the Bible, Christ is a black man. You know, when we see each other, we hate. Don't come here, come over. When we see each other, we hate ourselves. But when we see the so-called Chinese, the Arabs, the whites, we love them. But when we see our own kind, we hate them. Why? Because that's what the whites and Europeans have done to us. They've made us slaves and we hate ourselves. That's how God is saying they beat us into pieces. Read.
And grind the face of the poor.
How did they grind the face of the poor? Look at the condition we are in. They are taking our gold, our diamond, our resources, nothing. So they grind us as well, poor. They don't care about our condition we are in. All they care is about their money. The same thing applies to the pastors now. Do our pastors care for our sister? Sis, do our pastors care for us? No. Because well, look upon the money that they care for we, the members in the churches. They're supposed to use that money to develop what? The communities for us. But what did they do with that money? They pocket in their pocket and they leave you astray. That's what is going on here. Continue. Read.
Verse 3. Moreover, the Lord said, because the daughters of Zion are haughty.
He said, because our people are destroyed, are haughty, meaning they are spoiled. Mothers, fathers, everybody under Christianity, because we are spoiled as a people, we.
And what? We stretch forth next.
What we stretch forth next? Mean what? Everything we want. Everything our sisters want. That's why now they call themselves what? Slave queens. What does slave queens mean? What? Slave queen, what does it mean?
Come again?
Mean plenty things. Mean what? You want money, so what do you do? You sell your body, you sleep with somebody's husband, go up and down because of what? Money. Read.
And working eyes, working and missing as they go.
You work and missing as they go. Look at, we are working like zombies. We don't care what is going on in the world. We
and making a tinkle with their feet.
First of all, how we dress. So God says, well, our bodies are showing all over. We.
Therefore, the Lord will smite with a scarf the crown of the head of the daughters of Zion.
He said, what? The Lord will put a crown upon our head. Says, you have a natural hair. You have a woolly hair. Pure woolly like the Most High. What hair again do our sisters put on their head? Wig, is it natural or is it a dead fowl things? Our sisters, listen carefully. The wigs upon your head, they are what? Horses' hair, dead people's hair, sheep hair, like dead fowl's hair. That they used to make in the wigs for you people. So when you put on those wigs, God says it is what? Therefore, the Lord will smite with a scalp the crown of the head of the daughters of Zion. And the Lord will discover their secret parts. How did he? He said, the Lord said he will discover your secret part. How will God discover your secret part? How will God discover your secret part? Brothers, don't go far. Brothers, listen carefully. He sent you go to our sister here. He sent you must go to your younger sisters also. Sis, God says, well, because the way you go out dressed, so he's going to discover your secret part. Meaning what? Your inner part will be showing out. Your peace you wear under will be showing out. Your curves will be showing out. Have you seen? So it's not right for sisters to wear something that belongs to men. But if you wear those things, now the men will start to lust after you. That's what our younger ones are doing now. For God says, you shouldn't put all those things. Like how my mom is standing here. Mom, the attire that you are wearing is inappropriate. Because when you bear down, all your body will be showing. Understood? So sis, you need to change and put on dresses. Okay? As a princess, you need to cover your body. Like my mom like this. Have you seen? She has covered her body. She's your sister, right? She has covered her body. Nobody see her private part. But you, somebody will last after you. That's why you are here to warn you people. Wake up, you zombies, and keep God's commandments. We don't hate you. We don't hate nobody. We are here to show you the true love of God. That is understood? So God is, Jesus Christ is a black man. He's not a so-called white man. Understood? Anyway, you see these white images? Give you Deuteronomy chapter 7. Listen to what God says. Deuteronomy 7 to 5. This image is the beast the Bible speaks of. Only this image is the beast the Bible speaks of. Read Deuteronomy chapter 7. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 25. The graven images.
What?
The graven images. The graven images. That's these foolish man images. Read. Of their gods. Of their gods. Say, of their gods. Meaning, this God. Yakupon, on your God. So what you are saying? Any question? Yeah, exactly. Let me show you. Give me Daniel. You ask a question, you say, this picture doesn't mean God, right? Let's see how God look like. Let's see how God look like. And let's see how his son look like. And let's see how his children also what? Look like. Understood? Daniel 7. Read.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 9. I beheld till the truth were cast down.
This is King Daniel. King Daniel said, he saw the earth, meaning the kingdoms of this world, were destroyed down. Meaning all the rulership kingdoms were destroyed down. Read.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the ancients of days did sit.
If they said the ancients of days, who is the ancients of days? That's God. God is the ancient of this. He was before everything. Okay? So he's the ancient of this. Read.
And the ancient of days, the sixth, whose garment was white as snow, and the hair.
Listen, you know, bro. He said the ancient of this, he was sitting down, and his hair, meaning what? He have what? A body. So he have a hair on his head. So he said his hair, well, what?
And the hair of his head, right? The pure wool.
If they say pure wool, let me go straight to the point. We the blacks, we have the pure woolly hair. Have you seen? Like your hair, it's a pure wool. So that's how God also look like. Have you seen woolly carpet before? Woolly carpet. Have you seen the tester? When you roll it, how do you feel? You feel soft. When you roll your hair, how do your hair look like? Soft, that's woolly. Understood? That's how the black Messiah, that's what? The Messiah, that's how he has the woolly hair. So what? Like what? Like our brother here. Have you seen? This is a woolly hair. Oh, Yano. Okay. Yanoba, Onu.
That's a willing ear you have. Now give me revelation. Let's go to his son also. Let's see. Remember, he said the father has what? A willing ear, right? Let's see how the father, the son also look like. Down to verse 14 straight. Revelation chapter 1, verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool. Understood? He said what? The son of what? A white and woolly hair. Come over, look at here. Come. These images. Whose hair is white? Who have a white woolly hair? This and this. Who have a white woolly hair? This. Okay. Now let's continue. Read. His head and his hairs were white like wool, as white as snow. When we are growing old, when you become old, or when our forefathers become old and mothers, their hair turns which color? Gray hair, that's white. Because according to the Bible, that's the wisdom we have. Understood? So the same thing, because Christ was with the Father from the ancient of days. So his hair was white because he was in his glory. But when he came to being, his hair was became black like you and I. Understood? Wait. And his eyes were as a flame of fire. His eyes was as a flame of fire. When you drink, what was Christ's best marker? Christ's best marker, what was it? He turned water into wine. He will drink some, right? When you drink wine right now, what will your eye be? Your eye will turn red. When you take wine, your eyes will turn red. That's the prophecy about Christ, that Christ's eyes shall be red with wine. My mom, come over, let's learn. He said what? His eyes shall be red with wine. Continue. Verse 15. Verse 15. And his feet. And his feet. Now look at bro. John said, I saw Christ's feet. By the way, I can see your feet now. Okay? Read. And his feet like unto fine brass. If they say brass, have you seen this color? That is how it is, brown. Obviously, that's how brass it looked like. Let's see how John saw Christ's feet. Read. And his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace. Bro, when you burn this thing in a fire, what color do you think this would be again? It will melt. The way, this is brass. Brass color is not easy to melt in a fire like that. But when you bend it in the fire and bring it out, what color would that look again? It will change its color. To which color? When you cook rice and the rice burn, what color would that look like? Black. So when I burn this brown rice in the fire, what do you think it will look like? Black. So who are we reading now? We are reading about Jesus Christ. So is Christ a white one or a black person? It's a black person, understood? So if Christ is black, let's see his children. Where are his children? Jeremiah 14. Have you seen? Christ is a black man. Now let's see his children. Jeremiah 14, verse 2. Read. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 14, verse 2. Judah men and the gates thou of language. We are the Judah. We are the Jews. Because Christ is what? A Jew. We are the Jews. Christ also is a Jew. And he said we are good, we are mourning, right? Meaning what? We are crying. How are we crying? Because we are in captivity. We are in slavery. We are mourning because what? Our leaders are sleeping. Understood, bro? Wait. They are black unto the ground. Say the Jews are what? They are black unto the ground. Bro, what is the color of the soil? Black. Have you seen? So if Jesus Christ is a black man from the nation of Israel, and you are saying you are black, then meaning which nation are you from? From what? From Israel. Understood? So we are here to wake our people back to their true nationality. Ghana is not our biblical name. Ghana is not our biblical name. According to the Bible, God created 18 nations. Understood? God created 18 nations. And the 18 nations, he loved only one nation, which is the nation of Israel. So if you are walking, you say you call yourself a Christian, and you don't know the nation you are under from what? The Bible. Then you
you are a dead person. You are a dead man walking. Because you cannot find Ghana in the Bible. You cannot find Ghanaians in the Bible. You cannot find Nigerians in the Bible. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You cannot find Togolese, Nigerians. You cannot find Christianity in the Bible. You cannot find Methodists, Jehovah's Witness, SDA. You cannot find them in the Bible. So which nation as a people are we from according to the Bible? Sisters, sisters, this is not how you're supposed to dress. Sisters, you're supposed to dress decent. Okay? So you need to dress decent. But you need to dress you sisters need to dress decent. Show your younger ones how to dress. And stop selling your bodies like zombies walking. That's why you are here to warn them. You are here to warn our people to wake up and keep God's commandment. Bro, are you understand? Have you understood what is going on here? Because we are from the nation of Israel. And we're supposed to keep God's commandment. Because our leaders are not giving us what? The real understanding of what? The Bible. Understood? Do you have any question for us? No question. Look at our brothers here. Give me the 2028. Deuteronomy 28 verse 15. Bro, have you seen this coin? Look at the coins. You have front and back, right? The front is what? The head. And the back is what? The tail. Let's see what God also said to us. Verse 15. Deuteronomy 28 verse 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou art not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. Meaning if you don't listen to what God says to us, would to observe to do all his commandments. To do what? To observe to do all his commandments. Meaning if we don't keep God's commandments, we and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. But is curses a good thing or a bad thing? Curse, is it a good thing or a bad? It's a very bad thing, okay? So God says, well, if we don't keep his commandments, curses shall come upon us. Look at these things. Is it a good thing or a bad thing? Look at somebody selling your forefathers into slavery, into captivity. Is that good? It's very bad. But God says, well, it is a curse because we don't keep God's commandment. So all these things need to happen to us. Do you know anything about slavery? Do you know anything about slavery? What do you know about slavery? Forcing somebody to work for you with no payment, with no wages, and at the same time, what? They'll kill you in addition. It happened to our forefathers. Look at all these things here. It's a Bible prophecy, and this thing happened to our forefathers. And our forefathers, because they didn't keep God's commandments. So God says, so, all these curses shall come upon you and overtake thee. That's why we are suffering as a people. We don't have leaders to lead us. Our leaders are sleeping, dead and dumb. They just need our money and gone. But they don't care about the youth coming. So God, you are here. Give me some of the curses. 32. Deuteronomy 28 verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given to another people. He said, our sons and daughters. King, you are a king. Listen. Don't let the cat distract your mind. He said, what? Our sons and daughters shall be given unto us, another race of people. Which nation came to took us into slavery? Come again. Europeans. Understood? They came here, they forced us, took us into slavery. Because we the blacks, we didn't keep God's commandments. So God says, well, because you don't want to obey me now, I'll let you obey your slave master. I'll let you serve your slave master. That's what is going on here. Wait. And thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all day long. And there shall be no might in thine hand. Meaning when they were taking them away from our hand, we couldn't take them back. That's why we have our brothers in Europe now. In India, China, all over the world, they are spread over. Because we didn't keep God's commandments. Verse 33. Verse 33, the fruit of thy land and all thy labor. You say what? The fruit of thy land. Can I hear? What are some of the fruits that gives us money? The fruit that gives us money. Let me help you out. Our resources. our resources, diamond, bauxite, timber, gold, all those are resources that gives us money. But God says what? Reap the fruit of thy land and all thy labors upon all the fruit you have, and the labor that will work upon it, reap, shall a nation, bro, come, I saw you asking that question, come over. You say what? Shall a nation, meaning what? A nation that what? Let's see what. Shall a nation which thou knowest not, meaning a nation that we don't know them. Look at Diogo now. What are the nations we don't know them are in our midst? Nations that are among us with the blacks here. Who are they? The Nigerians are our people. We are what? The so-called white man. They are the strangers. The Europeans are here. The so-called Chinese man is here. The Arab man is here. The fact they are the same European people. God says that we, a nation which thou knowest not, eat up. The nation that we don't know them among us are going to eat our resources. They are eating our resources up to now. That's why we are poor. We don't know what is going on. That's why we are poor. We don't know what is going on. Continue. And thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always. That's why we don't look at the condition. Look at our data. You see, we are oppressed as a nation. Because we don't keep God's commandments. Is that clear? So right now, what are you supposed to do? We need to do what? That's right, bro. We need to start to obey what? God's commandment. We need to repent first. Give me half three. We need to repent first. Acts chapter 3 verse 19. The book of Acts chapter 3 verse 19. Repent ye therefore. Listen, God says do what? Repent ye therefore and be converted. Converted means something is going to change you.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.